Hello and welcome to my weekly video blog, and today on A.Vogel Talks Menopause I'm going to be talking about perimenopause periods, what's normal and what's not normal. If you like my tips and advice, then please subscribe and remember to hit the bell icon so you can be notified of all my new videos. Changes in your monthly period is very often one of the first signs that you are starting the approach to the menopause. For some women, these changes may be very slight, they may be hardly noticeable, and some women, their periods just stop and that's them in the menopause proper. But for the majority of women, there will be some kind of change to their monthly cycle. So I'm going to have a look today at what's considered normal. First of all, what causes all of these changes? As you start the journey towards the perimenopause, your estrogen and progesterone and testosterone levels start to decrease. Your body produces less. The problem is that it doesn't necessarily reduce them all gradually and within harmony with each other. So you can get very sudden dips of one hormone, which will cause one set of symptoms. If you get a really sudden dip of one of the other hormones, that will cause completely different symptoms. And these changes can sometimes just go completely all over the place with your hormones going up and down like a yo-yo. So every month can be completely different. So the normal period changes, number one, you may find that your periods become more frequent. If you're usually every 28 days, you might find them going down to every 26 days, even 24 days, or sometimes even less. You may find they get further apart. So it may well be that instead of the 28 days, they're coming every 38 days for a good few months. You may find that you get a missed period. So you have a normal period 1 month, and the next month they've just completely disappeared. And then the following month, they come back at the same regular time. Number two, you might find that your periods start to get later and later. So rather than just the 30 days, you might find that it starts off a few days later. The next month, they're even later. Then you might again go that 2 months. You know, some women find that they only get periods once every 3 months for a while. And I knew one lady, she had one period a year for 3 years in exactly the same date in the same month of that year. So there can be quite a huge gap between periods at this point. Number three, your periods can get shorter or longer. So if you normally had your periods at 5 days, you may find they only last 3 days, or you may find that they last 7 or 8 days between each one. Number four, they might get heavier or lighter. Some women say that maybe the first couple of days, their periods tend to be a little bit heavier and then it eases off. So you may find this time that the whole period is a lot heavier. You may find that, again, it's the complete opposite. Instead of being heavy for a couple of days, it might just be a completely light period, sometimes with very little bleeding, but you know it's there because you can feel it. Number five is spotting. So you can start to get spotting in between periods, round about day 14 or 15. Number six could be period pain. You may find that you start to get a lot more cramping, your periods are a lot more uncomfortable, or that any PMS symptoms that you had become more exaggerated. So you may find that you get really sore, tender breasts or nipples. You might get really bloated. You might get really severe sugar cravings, or you just find yourself really, really hungry the whole time. Number seven is you get the period cramps. So you get all the normal symptoms that your period is starting, but nothing comes. So in this situation, all that's happening here is that your hormones have still got a cycle, and many women find that they, once their periods stop, they still get a monthly cycle of symptoms, but just no period appearing. So what's not normal? It's when you get really heavy bleeding, where you find that you are having to change your tampons or your pads every couple of hours. You may find that you're getting clots with the bleeding. It may go on and on for days. And we've had some women who have bled heavily, continuously for over 3 weeks. Or you might find that you're really seriously flooding, that nothing is containing the blood and it's ending up in your clothes and everywhere else. If your periods are lasting more than 7 or 8 days, even if they're quite light, if they're just continuing for a lot longer, if you find that you're getting a period and then you're only having a break of maybe a week or a couple of weeks and you're getting another period, so there's a very short gap in between each period. So you may find that you get a combination of all of these. This is the point you really do need to go and see your doctor. The reason being, it can just be the hormones. You know, if they're really going all over the place, it can just be the natural process that's going on. But when you get to the perimenopause, other health issues can be a factor. A lot of women develop what's called fibroids, and these are little growths in the womb. They may have had them for years without causing any trouble, but when the womb itself starts to change, these fibroids can be irritated and they can just bleed continually. It could be polyps in the womb, it could be cysts. And again, these can cause that the frequent bleeding. It could be what's called a prolapse, and this is where the internal organs in the pelvic area, so this is your womb, your bladder, and your bowel, they can all change position, they can shift slightly, and either the bowel or the bladder can start to put extra pressure on the womb, it can even pinch the womb, and again, that can cause the heavy bleeding. So this is one of these instances, if you're getting any of these particular symptoms, please see your doctor first, because all of these may need treatment of some kind. And if your doctor is not quick at looking at this, because a lot of women, once they get these particular symptoms, they're offered a scan or an ultrasound just to see what's going on. So make sure as well that you get offered one of these just so that things can be checked out properly. For the minor changes that go on with your periods, there are some things that you can take that are naturally. So that would be things like Agnus Castus. If your periods start to get just a little bit heavier, if they start to get just a little bit longer, so we're talking 1 or 2 days heavy, maybe your periods are lasting an extra couple of days, the herb Agnus Castus is known to help. But it takes 2 to 3 months to kick in, so you do have to persevere with this one. If your periods are starting to tail off, if they're starting to miss, if they're starting to get less heavy, you can look at the menopause support, because this can help just to balance things out. If your periods are a little bit more frequent or heavy, an iron supplement is really important, because low iron can cause fatigue, low mood, anxiety, joint pain, and poor sleep. The other things that you need to do when your periods start to change is to track them, because then it may give you an idea of how long you're going in between periods. You know, I've had some women that have suddenly gone, oh, I've not had a period for 6 months, but they can't remember exactly when the last one was. And you need to know when your last period is in order to know whether you're in the menopause proper and what's then going to happen then. Normally, you are considered in the menopause when you've not had any periods for 2 years. I know some sources say 1 year, but in our experience over the years, quite a large number of women can go a year or more without a period, and then get them back again. So it's really important. You can just use your calendar. You can get apps now that can be really helpful at seeing what's going on. So I hope you found this one helpful. It's a big subject. Definitely the perimenopause, there's lots of changes can go on. If any of you had any other symptoms that you're wondering whether this is the perimenopause or not, please ask and I'll be happy to help. And until then, I will see you next week for another edition of A.Vogel Talks Menopause.